When implementing a new privacy program, what is the first step a privacy manager should take? A. Train the employees on privacy matters. B. Define the scope and objectives of the privacy program. C. Conduct a privacy impact assessment. D. Update the privacy policy. Correct answer. B. Define the scope and objectives of the privacy program. What is the most important consideration when sharing personal data with third-party vendors? A. The cost of the service provided by the vendor. B. The geographical location of the vendor. C. Ensuring the vendor has adequate privacy safeguards in place. The speed at which the vendor can process the data. Correct answer. C. Ensuring the vendor has adequate privacy safeguards in place. In the context of privacy by design, when should privacy controls be integrated into a new product? A. After the product is developed but before it is launched. B. Only if customers request privacy features. C. During the initial planning and design phases. D. As a final step in the product development process. Correct answer. C. During the initial planning and design phases. How should a company respond to a customer's request to delete their personal data under GDPR? A. Ignore the request as it may not be genuine. B. Delete the data within 30 days if it is not needed for legal or legitimate business purposes. C. Offer the customer a discount to persuade them not to delete their data. D. Transfer the data to a third party for confirmation. Correct answer. B. Delete the data within 30 days if it is not needed for legal or legitimate business purposes. What role does employee training play in a privacy program? A. It is only necessary for new employees. B. It is an optional part of privacy awareness. C. It is crucial for ensuring all employees understand their privacy responsibilities. D. It should be conducted only after a data breach occurs. Correct answer. C. It is crucial for ensuring all employees understand their privacy responsibilities. How should privacy impact assessments, PIAs, be used in project management? A. Only for projects involving new technologies. B. As a retrospective analysis after project completion. C. Throughout the project lifecycle to identify and mitigate privacy risks. D. PIAs are not necessary for project management. Correct answer. C. Throughout the project lifecycle to identify and mitigate privacy risks. What is a key component of managing privacy in a multinational company? A. Applying the strictest privacy laws company-wide. B. Adhering only to the privacy laws of the country where the company is headquartered. C. Tailoring privacy practices to each individual country's laws. D. Ignoring international laws if they conflict with local laws. Correct answer. A. Applying the strictest privacy laws company-wide. When collecting personal data, what information must be provided to individuals according to transparency requirements? A. Only the purpose of data collection. B. The data collection methods used. C. The purpose of data collection, how it will be used, and their rights concerning the data. D. The types of data collected and the names of third parties accessing the data. Correct answer. C. The purpose of data collection, how it will be used, and their rights concerning their data. What is the best practice for responding to a legal request for customer data? A. Provide all requested data without reviewing the request. B. Deny all requests to protect customer privacy. C. Review the request's legality and relevance before complying. D. Ask the customer to directly respond to the request. Correct answer. C. Review the request's legality and relevance before complying. Which of the following is a critical step when transferring personal data across borders? A. Automatically transferring data without any restrictions. B. Ensuring the receiving country has adequate data protection laws. C. Only transferring data at the request of the data subject. D. Sending data through encrypted emails only. Correct answer. B. Ensuring the receiving country has adequate data protection laws. How should a privacy manager handle a situation where a new technology could significantly impact privacy but also offer substantial business benefits? A. Reject the technology outright to avoid privacy risks. B. Adopt the technology immediately to gain its benefits. C. Conduct a thorough risk assessment to balance privacy concerns with business benefits. D. Leave the decision to the technology team. Correct answer. C. Conduct a thorough risk assessment to balance privacy concerns with business benefits. When developing a privacy policy, what is essential to ensure its effectiveness? A. Making it as brief as possible. B. Using technical jargon to ensure accuracy. C. Tailoring it to the audience's level of understanding. D. Updating it only when privacy laws change. Correct answer. C. Tailoring it to the audience's level of understanding. What action should a privacy manager take when they notice a gap in compliance with privacy laws? A. Wait for a legal notice before taking any action. B. Immediately implement corrective measures to address the gap. C. Only focus on gaps with the highest financial penalties. D. Document the gap and plan to address it in the next fiscal year. Correct answer. B. Immediately implement corrective measures to address the gap. In what situation is it necessary to appoint a data protection officer, DPO? A. When the company decides to implement a privacy program. B. Only if the company processes data of EU citizens. C. Based on the size of the company. D. If the core activities require regular and systematic monitoring of data subjects on a large scale. Correct answer. D. If the core activities require regular and systematic monitoring of data subjects on a large scale. How should a company proceed when it discovers that a third-party processor is not complying with its data protection obligations? A. Continue the partnership as ending it would be too costly. B. Report the processor to the relevant data protection authorities. C. Work with the processor to improve their compliance. D. Immediately terminate the contract without investigation. Correct answer. C. Work with the processor to improve their compliance. What is the best approach to ensure ongoing compliance with evolving privacy regulations? A. Conduct annual training sessions for the privacy team. B. Implement a privacy program and do not change it. C. Regularly review and update privacy policies and procedures. D. Only update privacy practices following a data breach. Correct answer. C. Regularly review and update privacy policies and procedures. Which action is most appropriate when a new privacy law is enacted? A. Assume current practices are already compliant. B. Wait for guidance from regulatory authorities before making any changes. C. Immediately conduct a gap analysis to identify necessary adjustments. D. Only make changes if competitors do so. Correct answer. C. Immediately conduct a gap analysis to identify necessary adjustments. How should a privacy manager prioritize privacy risks? A. By focusing on risks with the easiest solutions. B. Based on the potential impact on the organization and individuals. C. Only addressing risks mentioned in recent audits. D. Prioritizing risks that are most publicly visible. Correct answer. B. Based on the potential impact on the organization and individuals. When integrating a new system, what is a key privacy consideration? A. How quickly the system can be deployed. B. The cost of the system. C. Ensuring it supports compliance with applicable privacy laws. D. The color scheme of the user interface. Correct answer. C. Ensuring it supports compliance with applicable privacy laws.